Hello friends, welcome back. This session we will discuss the current affairs of second week of April, part 2. First news is international news. The Israeli military has bombarded rockets in different areas in Gaza. It is the most intense airstrike in Gaza since 2014. Hamas, the terror organization, has fired hundreds of rockets towards Hello friends, welcome back. In this session we will discuss the current affairs of April 2nd week of part 2. Here we go with the first international current affair. Hostilities between Israel and Hamas escalated and resulted in airstrike between the two countries. Capital of Israel is Jerusalem and currency is Israel shekel, and Prime Minister of Israel is Benjamin Netanyahu. World Bank report projects that India has largest recipient of remittances in 2020. And it is as per the migration development brief released by the World Bank. However, the remittance received by India in 2020 was over $83 billion, which is a drop of 0.2% from 2019. Globally, remittances flow was $540 billion in 2020, which is 1.9% lower as compared to 2019. Top 5 remittance recipient countries in 2020 in US dollar terms were India, China, Mexico, Philippines, and Egypt. World Bank headquarters is in Washington, D.C., and its president is David Malpass. It was formed in 1944, July. Nepal's K.P. Sharma Oli reappointed as the Prime Minister of the country, and President is Bindia Devi Bhandari. This will be his third stint as the Prime Minister. World Health Organization classified Indian coronavirus variants as global variant of concern. The variant named B1.617, according to World Health Organization, has spread to more than 30 countries. This variant is also called the double mutant variant. It was first identified by the United Kingdom health authorities. World Health Organization was established on 7th April 1948 and is a specialized agency of United States responsible for international public health. World Health Organization headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland, and current president is Dr. Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus. China becomes the world's first country to ban synthetic cannabinoids. The ban is likely to come into effect on July 1, 2021. Capital of China is Beijing, currency is renminbi, and president is Xi Jinping. We move on to national news. The cabinet has approved the cabinet of Union Government of India. Union of Government of India has approved signing of MOU between Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and Qatar Finance Service Center Authority. This will enhance cooperation between the institutes to work together to strengthen the accounting profession and entrepreneurship based in Qatar. According to State of Healthcare in India report by Elara Technologies, it showed that Pune was the most health-equipped city in India. 69% of the hospital beds in India are concentrated in urban areas, which is another important information that we derive from the report. We move on to next news. The PM Kisan Samman Nidhi 8th installment released by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The Government of India has transferred 6,000 rupees to account of small and marginal farmers. These funds are transferred in 3 installments. The first installment of rupees 2,000 was made between April and June, second between August and November, and third installment December and March. We move on to state news. Delhi Police had launched a helpline for senior citizens who are struggling with their essential needs amid COVID-19. The initiative is known as CoviVan Helpline, and it will help senior citizens get their essentials as and when needed. Chief Minister of Delhi is Arvind Kejriwal. Lieutenant Governor of Delhi is Anil Baijal. Chief Minister of Punjab, Amrinder Singh, has declared Malerkotla as the 23rd district of the state on 14th May 2021 on the occasion of Eid ul-Fitr. Malerkotla is a Muslim-dominated area and has been carved out of Sangruru district of the state. CM of Punjab is Captain Amrinder Singh. Governor is VP Singh Badnol. Uttarakhand Police launches Mission Hausala to help people get oxygen, beds, ventilators and plasma for COVID-19 patients. The Chief Minister of Uttarakhand is Tiraj Singh Rawat. Governor of Uttarakhand is Baby Rani Maurya. Appointments: Arun Kumar Singh named as the next CMD of BPCL by the Public Enterprises Selection Board. His selection was ratified by the Appoints Committee of the Union Government Cabinet. Presently, K. Padmakumar is holding additional charge of BPCL's CMD after D. Rajkumar retired in August 2020. Manisha Kapoor joins Executive Committee of International Counseling on Advertising Self-Regulation. The President of ICAS is Guy Parker. Headquarters is in Brussels, capital of Belgium. Martin Griffiths appointed as the UN Humanitarian Chief. He is a British diplomat and was appointed as the Chief of United Nations Office of the Coordination Humanitarian Affairs for a period of 5 years. He is currently serving as the United Nations Special Envoy for Yemen. Sir David Attenborough named the COP26 People's Advocate. The COP26 UN Climate Change Conference of Parties. Sir David Attenborough is a world-renowned broadcaster, natural historian, and he inspired millions of people in the UK and around the world with his passion and knowledge to act on climate change and protect the planet for the future generations. We move on to banking and finance. The Securities Exchange Board of India has proposed to rationalize the definition of promoter group and to move to the concept of person in control, as well as lower the minimum lock-in periods for promoters and other shareholders after an IPO. The IRDAI has imposed penalty of Rs 30 lakh on SBI General Insurance Company due to the failure to comply with the third-party motor insurance regulation as specified by the concerned IRDAI regulations for 2018-2019. The chairman of IRDAI is Subhash Chandra Kundia. As per the National Statistics Organization report, the retail inflation eases to 4.29% in April, and India's factory output measured in terms of index of industrial production witnessed a growth of 22.4% in March. The data were released by Ministry of Statistics and Program and Implementation. Google Pay users in US now can transfer money to India, Singapore. And Alphabet Incorporated's Google has launched international money transfer partnership with remittance firms Wise and Western Union Co. for users of the US payments app. The Reserve Bank of India has granted authorization to En-ROAD Technologies to operate as a prepaid payment instruments company. The En-ROAD Technologies MD CEO is Sanjeev Pandey. Jio did sign an ink pact with PNB to offer 3-in-1 account. The PNB headquarters is in New Delhi. The MD CEO is SS Mallikarjuna Rao. RBI cancels license of United Cooperative Bank over inadequate capital, regulatory non-compliance, and this bank is based in Baganak in West Bengal. 25th RBI Governor is Shaktikant Das and headquarters is in Mumbai, and it was founded on 1st April 1935 in Kolkata. Airtel Payments Bank launches Digi Gold, a digital platform for customers to make investments in gold. This has been rolled out in partnership with Safe Gold, a provider for digital gold. With the Digi Gold, Airtel Payments Bank saving account customers can invest in 24-karat gold using Airtel Thanks app. We move on to awards. Shakuntala Harksingh Thistle wins World Food Prize 2021 for her groundbreaking research in developing holistic and nutrition-sensitive approaches to aquaculture and food systems. She is a global nutrition expert. World Food Prize is presented by World Food Prize Foundation. It was first awarded in 1987. We move on to summits and conferences. India chairs first BRICS Employment Working Group meeting. The BRICS meeting was held under the chairmanship of India. Meeting was chaired by Sri Apurva Chandra, Secretary, Labour and Employment. Fourth India-Swiss Financial Dialogue held virtually. Economic Affairs Secretary Ajay Seth represented the Indian delegation. We move on to miscellaneous news. Harley Davidson launches all-electric motorcycle brand Livewire. The latest effort by the company to ramp up bets on the rapidly growing electric vehicle market. New Zealand PM Jacinda Ardern tops Fortune World's 50 Great Leaders 2021. The World's 50 Greatest Leaders 2021 is 8th edition of the annual list which celebrates leaders and some well-known others who aren't so familiar who made differences amid the truly unprecedented times of the COVID-19 pandemic. From India, Adar Poonawalla, Chief Executive Officer of Serum Institute of India, is the only Indian among top 10. He is placed in the 10th spot. Airline company Go Air rebrands itself as Go First and its motto, You Come First. The decision to rebrand after 15 years is part of the company's attempt to operate the carrier in an ULCC ultra low-cost carrier airline model and tide over the impact of COVID-19 pandemic. The Go Air founder is Jahangir Wadia and it was founded in 2005. Go Air headquarters is in Mumbai. With this, we come to the conclusion of this session. Stay tuned for our next session. We'll be back soon.
If you enjoyed this video, please do like and share. Subscribe to this channel to receive expert tips and guidance for clearing various placement exams. And press the bell icon to receive instant notifications.